Assisting hatching is a conflicting issue in the field of IVF. It has been used for many years now. There is a lot of research behind it, but no conclusive evidence that it can really help. Just to explain a bit about assisted hatching, egg oocyte has got a protein membrane around it, which is called zona pellucida. After the fertilization of the sperm, this goes harder and goes around the embryo. The reason for that is so that not more sperms intrude the embryo, and also another reason behind it is so that the embryo will not implant in the tubes before reaching the uterine cavity and give an ectopic pregnancy. When the embryo moves from the tubes inside the cavity of the womb, the zona pellucida usually gets thinner, and this helps in the opposition attachment and invasion of the embryo to the lining of the womb. Scientists observed that day 3 embryos that had a thinner zona pellucida had better implantation rates, and also when a blastocyst had some natural holes around it, the implantation rates were better too. So they thought about artificially perforating the membrane and manipulating with the membrane, which is called zona pellucida, and this is called assisted hatching. It can be done by many ways. The best and the safest one is laser. Generally, in many studies, it has shown that can improve the clinical pregnancy rates, but in large meta-analysis and Cochrane data, it has been shown that it doesn't really change the live birth rate. Given of that, it would not be recommended for any IVF. Actually, there is some evidence that when we talk about a good quality embryo, it can make things worse rather than better. But there is some evidence in repeated unexplained failures, in previous failed IVFs, in older women with not good quality of embryos. Thank you.